Hello everyone, and welcome to this mini tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to recreate this logo animation using Move by Linearity. Let's start by creating a new file. Go to File, New. As a resolution, pick the preset square. And let's leave the frame rate at 30 FPS. Click Confirm. We're going to import elements into our scene from Curve. Click New Scene, Import, and select the file provided called logoanimation.curve. Click Open. In the Import panel, you will see as many artboards as the one in your Curve file, which in this case is just one. Click the artboard, drag and drop it into the Scene Builder line. Click Import. Double-click into Scene 1 to start editing your animation. As you can see, the file is very well organized. We have the main group called Logo, and then two subgroups. One for the logotype, which contains every letter that forms the word linearity, and another one for the icon. We're going to animate each group depending on what animation we want to apply to each section of the logo. I'm going to start by animating the logo icon. Let's zoom in. I'm going to recreate a reveal animation using masks. First of all, we have to create the shapes that will be masking our icon. Before we do that, let's switch to design mode. When we are in design mode, we can edit our composition as much as we like without affecting keyframes of the animation in the timeline. I'm going to select the rectangle tool in the toolbar on the left. And make sure that you pick a contrasting color that will stand out on the orange background. I pick blue. I'm going to create my shape starting from the left side. To create a square, hold Shift, click, and drag. I need to see what's going on underneath this shape, so I'm going to tweak the opacity from 100% to roughly 50%. Zoom in and make sure you position the edge of the square to where the two sides of the icon touch. I need a second square for the other side of the icon, so I'm going to copy and paste the shape. To copy, click Command C, and to paste, Command V. And now just click and drag to reposition it. I'm going to zoom in to make sure that we position everything pixel perfect. And zoom out. I'm going to rename the two squares on my layer panel. It's important to give every shape on your layer panel a unique name. This way will be easier to work with them later on in the animation. Now it's time to create our mask. To do that, open up the layers in the icon group. You can see they're divided into right side of the icon and left side of the icon. We're going to pick the square left and move it underneath the icon left group. Hold Shift and select both. Then right click and select Mask Selection. We've successfully created our first mask. Let's rename the group. Now we do the same for the right side. Pick the square right and drag it in the layer panel until it is below the icon right. Then select both by holding Shift, right click, and Mask Selection. Don't forget to rename your group. Now that we've created the mask, we can enable the fill color. To do that, select the square, go into the Style panel on the right, and disable fill color. Do the same for the other square. Now it's time to animate our mask. To do that, first we have to switch back to animate mode. Let's zoom in a little bit onto our timeline. We're going to start animating the left side of the icon. I'm going to use the node tool to select one corner of the rectangle. I select the top left corner, click and drag it until it is overlapping the bottom right corner. I'm going to zoom in to make sure the positioning is correct. Perfect. Then I'm going onto the timeline and move the playhead to second number one. Using the node tool, I click again on that corner and move it to where it was before. Let's preview what we just did. We created two keyframes on the timeline, and when we play, they create this reveal animation on the left side of the icon. Let's do the same with the right side. Select the mask, and using the node tool, we're going to select the bottom right corner and drag it until it is on top of the top left corner. Zoom in to make sure the positioning is correct. And zoom out a little bit. Move the playhead to second one. And just like we did before, we're going to select that corner and put it back to where it was. This way, we have both sides revealing themselves. To make it more interesting, we can create a bit of a delay. We want the left side to go first, and then the right side to go next. To create a delay, select the animation bar corresponding to the group, and then click and drag it. Let's preview what it looks like now. You will see that the reveal happens almost simultaneously, but with that little bit of delay, it looks more interesting. Now we're going to animate the letters. All the letters are contained inside a group called Logotype. To animate the group, you just need to select Logotype and create your animation. But we want to take this a step further. We're going to animate each single letter. To do that, make sure that you select the letter from inside the group. I'm going to click letter 1, hold shift, and click letter 9. This way now they're all selected. To move the text, I'm going to select and drag while holding shift to make sure that it moves in a straight line. I'm also going to change the opacity from 100% to 0%. Let's preview our animation. As you can see, the text is disappearing, but we want it to reveal itself. We can switch things around by simply clicking on the animation bar corresponding to the Logotype group, select the keyframes on the far left, click and drag them on the opposite side of the animation. Let's preview it now. This is exactly what we wanted. To make things more interesting, I suggest we delay the beginning of the animation of each letter a little bit. To do that, just move the playhead a couple of bars on the then select the letter, drag the animation bar until it reaches the playhead, and do the same for each letter. Make sure to keep the space between each letter even. Let's put the playhead at the beginning, the animation, and preview what's animated so far. Perfect! This logo animation is almost complete. To add a final touch, we're going to change the scene by adding a zoom-in effect. This time we're going to apply the animation to the entire logo, deselect all the groups. We're not going to change anything on them anymore. Select the logo group. We're going to start by changing the size of the logo. To do so, we're going to use the style panel. Follow my lead and input the following values. Make sure that the lock icon is selected for a proportion change in the size, and then change the width to 2380 pixel. We also want to change the position of the logo. Our start position is going to be 240, and on the second axis, 370. Let's move the playhead to the end of the revealing animations and change the position so that the logo will move from left to right. This time, we're going to change only the value of the first axis to minus 1575. Hit return. Let's preview our animation. As you can see, as the revealing animation happens, everything is moving from left to right. But we want the position to start changing after the icon has finished its revealing. So move the playhead to roughly where the icon animation finishes. Select the keyframe of the position and move it. Let's see how it works now. Perfect. Last but not least, we're going to change the scale so that we zoom out once the logo is fully revealed. Move the size keyframe at the end of the positioning animation. Then move the playhead a couple of bars. This time we have to change both the size and the end position of our logo. Let's start with the size. We want it to be smaller, so we're going to enter the value we had before. And now we have to recenter the logo. To do that, you can use the aligning options here at the top of the Style tab. So we're going to align center and align center. I'm going to zoom out in my timeline so I can see everything. Move in the playhead at the beginning and preview my animation again. Perfect! Just slightly too fast at the end, so we're going to change that by simply delaying the last keyframe. This should work. Let's preview the animation again. And that's done. Don't forget to export and share your results with us. Thank you for joining me today. Let's see you in the next tutorial.